Hello students, the question: area bounded by x square minus y square equal to 3 and x square plus y square equal to 5. X square minus y square equal to 3 is a hyperbola, a rectangular hyperbola. The standard form of rectangular hyperbola, x square minus y square equal to a square, and x square plus y square equal to 5 is a circle having center 0, 0 and radius root 5. So we have to find where the two, that is hyperbola and the circle, intersect or meet each other. And to solve, x square minus y square equal to 3 and x square plus y square equal to 5. Okay, and what is x square? X square equal to 3 plus y square. The same x square from circle, 5 minus y square. And then 3 plus y square will be equal to 5 minus y square. Then 2y square is 5 minus 2. And y square equal to 1, and y will be equal to plus or minus 1. Okay. So when y equal to 1, x square from circle plus 1 equal to 5, x square equal to 4, and x equal to plus or minus 2. Then as well as y equal to minus 1, y square equal to, y equal to minus 1, the same result will come. X square plus 1. So x equal to plus or minus 2. So based on this information, we can complete our rough sketching of the given one. X square plus y square equal to 5, the center 0, 0. And radius root 5 units. So what about this point? And root 5 comma 0. And the left side of x axis, minus root 5 comma 0. The root 5 more than 2.3 or less than 2.5. And x square plus y square equal to 3 square. What is the standard form of rectangular hyperbola? X square minus y square equal to a square. So a equal to root 3, and root 3 is less than root 5. So this is rectangular hyperbola. What about this point? The distance a. So root 3 comma 0. This is minus root 3 comma 0. The center of the rectangular hyperbola 0 comma 0, as well as the center of the circle 0 comma 0. So the bounded area, this is the required area. This is the required area. And we have got point of intersection, there y equal to plus 1 and y equal to minus 1. Knowing the right side area, by multiplying by 2, we can get these two area. Why? Because the area is symmetrical about both x axis and y axis. When we replace y by minus y or x by minus x, there is no change. Both hyperbola and the circle are symmetric about both the x axis and y axis, so the two areas will be equal. So just let us find area on the right side of x equal y equal to 0, that is x axis. So to find the area under circle between minus 1 to 1 minus area under hyperbola from minus 1 to 1. Okay, so for that we can draw one horizontal strip. What is the area of the horizontal rectangular strip with respect to y axis? This is x2 minus x1. X2 minus x1 dx. And x2 is circle, x1 is parabola. That is rectangular, not parabola, hyperbola, rectangular hyperbola. Okay. So now we are going to integrate with respect to y-axis, because we have selected rectangular strip. Area of the rectangular strip is x2 minus x1, and x2 is nothing but x coordinate of the second curve, that is circle. X1 is x coordinate of the first one, is nothing but rectangular hyperbola. Okay, so go through it. We'll continue. Now, what is bounded area? Bounded area according to R, and what is the symmetric property? We take first function f, f of x comma y equal to x square minus y square minus 3 is the same as f of minus x comma minus y, as well as if we take g of x second function, g of x comma y is circle x square plus y square minus 5 will also be equal to g of minus x comma minus y. That means, and both the curves symmetric about both x axis and y axis. So this is the required area. So in the required area, or area bounded by x square minus y square equal to 3 and x square plus y square equal to 5, from the figure, area A equal to 2 times x2 minus x1 and dy, lower limit of y is minus 1. According to the figure, upper limit of y is plus 1. Then 2 times minus 1 to 1, x2, the second curve, that is circle, x equal to root of 5 minus y square dy. Then minus 2 times, separating now, minus 1 to 1, and x of hyperbola 3 plus y square, root of 3 plus y square dy. Okay, listen, because of the y square and y square, both are even function, so applying property we can write it 4 times 0 to 1, here there also 4 times 0 to 1, then 4 times 0 to 1 root of 5 minus y square dy, again 4 times 0 to 1 root of 3 plus y square dy. What is the reason behind this? Both the integrand or even function. What is even function? F of y or f of minus y equal mean the function f in y is even function. So the expression in y is even. Okay. Now, we will continue. Then 4 times, apply integral formula y by 2 and root of 5 minus y square plus a square by 2, 5 by 2 sine inverse of y by root 5 and 0 to 1. Then minus the integral of this y by 2 root of 3 plus y square plus 3 by 2 log mod of x plus root of y plus root of 3 plus y square 0 to 1. Then you have to apply upper limit and lower limit term wise. Go through it. then 4y by 2, 2, upper limit 5 minus 1, 4, so 2 into 1, 2. So 4 by 2 is 2, y into root of 5 minus y square, if we take upper limit, y equal to 1 and 5 minus 1, root 4 is 2, positive root, and low limit because of y is 0. Plus 4 into 5 by 2, 10. And sine inverse of 1 by root 5. Yes, low limit, 0 by root 5, sine inverse of 0, 0. Then minus and 4 by 2, 2. Upper limit 1. So 3 is 3 plus 1, 4. And 1, again 2. A low limit 0, so 2. Minus 4 into 3 by 2, minus 6 and log of 1 plus and 3 plus 1, 4, 2, 2 plus 1, 3. So log 3 and low limit and 0, 0 and minus log root of 3, okay? Yeah. Then 2 into 2, 4, plus 10, sine inverse of 1 by root 5, minus 4, then minus 6, log of, we can simplify further, log 3, minus 1 by 2 log 3, okay? Because of root, 3 bar 1 by 2, 1 by 2 log 3. So log 3 minus 1 by 2 log 3, 1 by 2 log 3. Then this and this cancel, 10 times sine inverse of 1 by root 5, then minus 6, log 3 minus 1 by 2 log 3, log 3 by 2, so 3 log 3 or log 3 cube, 27. Then 10 sine inverse of 1 by root 5 and minus log 3 cube 27, taking modulus, so this is required area, square units, okay, and go through it.